You're very welcome to Newstalk's big 20th birthday quiz. All this week on the station, we've been celebrating two decades of Newstalk on air. And what better way to round off these celebrations than by testing the brain power, the knowledge and the wherewithal of some of my finest Newstalk colleagues. So on one team, Shane and Ciara, Newstalk Breakfast, Andrea and Henry as well, their opponents today. Henry, a lot of these are Newstalk focused questions. You're here since Kieran. Day one, the big bang.
Well, I like to see myself as fresh and new, maybe 2 years in the building. But no, yes, I joined Newstalk, started up in April 2002. I joined in June 2002. So I showed up and to be honest with you, nobody knew what they were doing. And then I showed up and things just went downhill from there.
20 years later, you still know.
No.
Dude, were you on one of those famous orange scooters? Were you one of those?
Yeah, I did have an orange Vespa, which I used to drive around. We actually lost a few of them. Some of the local children stole them and threw them in the canal. So I had the last one remaining scooter, orange one. I remember having to drive to Tala in it. And back then, Tala was a faraway place. And it was snowing. And it was tough. It was a tough drive on that old scooter.
I'm sorry. The Vespas were orange and had the Newstalk logo.
That was
on
our colour back then, yeah. Orange.
Like the way the spinnies drive around and stuff like that.
That's kind of a nice idea.
Yeah, I know. They should bring it back. I think, despite the fact that you're here a long time, it feels here because of like the slot and George and, well, you know, you're
it just feels like a long time, yes.
You're probably here the least.
Oh, I'm definitely here the least. So I'm just passing through, Kieran. I'd say I'd probably only last till the end of about next week. Do you know what I mean?
Well, the Jane Laws are next.
Yeah, I know. You're absolutely right.
Right, I'll tell you what. We'll get things going. Question one, round one. So there's a lot at stake here. I'm not going to reveal the prize until the end, but there is a great prize for the winning team. That's all I'll say. So Henry mentioned that April 9th of April, to be precise, 2002, the very first Newstalk broadcast. Andrea and Henry, who presented that very first show?
Oh, can we confer? Or do you know?
Yes, she's your teammate. You're allowed to confer.
Oh, we can confer. Yes. Okay, so I hope I get this right. The first ever broadcast was David McWilliams.
Well, let's take a little listen to a clip, find out if you're right.
Good morning, I'm David McWilliams. Coming up, this week marks the second anniversary of the dot-com collapse. And in the first of a four-part series, we focus on the lasting legacy of the bull market. And particularly this morning, we focus on television and how the bull market in telecoms and in dot-coms has affected how we watch television, what is on television, and the future of Irish and European television. And we also take the opportunity to look at Britain. Is it a united kingdom or a disunited kingdom? The Queen Mother's funeral reflects the passing of an era, and we ask David Burnside, the MP for Antrim, what it now means to be British.
2020 News on News Talk 106.
2020 News. What? Does anyone you remember that?
I do remember 2020
News. 7 minutes of news every 20 minutes.
Whatever happened to David McWilliams, though?
I know, the energy or the lack of
it. Yeah, what a punchy intro.
I know, yeah. Question two for Shane and Ciara. What item did Tom Dunn give away to listeners every day on his morning show and News Talk?
Oh, God. Wasn't it Something Happens t-shirt, I presume?
Was it a mug? Was there a Tom Dunn mug?
Oh, Henry knows. I know.
Henry, you little.
I'm trying to rack my brain.
It's not a. Well, I don't know. We'll say a Tom Dunn mug.
A Tom Dunn mug. Well, I have it here in my hand. I cannot believe you've forgotten.
Of course.
A Tom Dunn nudie pen.
We gave away pens.
Yes. Sorry, Ciara, you do, this looks like news to you.
It is news to me.
And you can see his member.
Tom Dunn fully clothed.
Yeah.
Tom Dunn. In the nude, when you turn the pen upside down.
Not fully in the nude.
Well, he's got his underwear on.
Oh, he is in underwear, yeah, I forgot.
It's enough pen. In the nude.
That is Jess Kelly's Tom Dunn nudie pen. There are very, very few nudie pens left. Jess has hoarded most of them. Anyway.
What marketing whiz came up with that idea?
All right, okay. Already behind Shane and Ciara. Andrea and Henry, question three. What year did Pat Kenny join News Talk?
I know the answer to this.
That was quick.
2013.
How do you know that so quickly?
Because I joined in 2013.
Wow. You and Pat.
Me and Pat.
The big Andrea and Pat reveal.
Once I came that May, he followed that September, Kieran.
You came before. All right. We actually have a little clip, though, of Pat Kenny's first ever broadcast here.
Good morning and welcome, and wherever you are, thank you very much for joining me on my first show on News Talk. A special welcome to those who have moved the dial and to those who normally listen to this station at this time. My aim is to keep you entertained as well. In a few minutes' time, Bono on his interrupted mission to Ghana and Liberia on Scientology and on Seamus Heaney. Ivan Yates on his return from UK bankruptcy.
Remember Ivan Yates? A few questions about Ivan Yates coming up. Anyway, question...
I was hoping you were going to ask me who the first guest was, and I knew it was Bono, yeah. But that's not the question.
Was Bono his first guest?
Yeah.
I didn't remember that now.
You didn't listen at all.
What? Shane and Ciara, question four. Which of the following people did not present News Talk Breakfast? Have not presented News Talk Breakfast.
Ooh. Okay.
Nora Casey, Paul Williams, Tom Dunn.
Tom Dunn.
Tom Dunn.
Very quick.
Even I knew that.
You would have presented with Nora as well, filling in, wouldn't you?
Filled in with Nora, and obviously I presented with Paul for a few years. So, yeah, that's a nice easy.
Second opportunity to mention Ivan's bankruptcy there.
He's bankrupt anyway. Again, isn't he? I wonder where
it's
he went.
It's just non-stop,
to.
Henry, isn't it?
Anyway, two digs in a row at Ivan Yates. 2-1 in favour of Henry and Andrea. And we've got a video clip for our next question. Here is Jonathan Healy.
Hello there, Newstalk people. Welcome to Cork. Now, we all know that the current studio for Newstalk in the real capital is the Republic of Work. But my exceptionally complicated and difficult question is, where was our first Cork studio?
Is that their question? Can we have that question?
No, you cannot have that.
Can we get a consolation point if they don't know it?
Okay, I'll give it over if you don't know. But I suspect the way Henry is looking confident there. Look, the chest is out. The head is up.
I think I know this
power
one.
Pose.
You heard Jonathan there. I mean, he kept going on about Cork. He wouldn't stop going on about Cork.
He's still going on about it.
You heard him there. But yes, we did have a studio in Cork, but it wasn't really a studio. I hope that's okay to say. It was more of a broom cupboard or a shop window
with a huge window.
A shop window kind of prefab.
Booth, basically.
Yeah, it was a telephone booth. And if I get this right, it was off Patrick Street. It was Opera Lane, as I used to like to call it, Oprah Lane.
Oprah Lane, very good, very good.
Was there a toilet, or did you have to go to a...
I think you had to walk through Penny's.
People used to lick the window when you were sitting on air.
That was only when you were on.
Yeah, exactly. So anyway, Henry is right, of course, and thank you to Jonathan Healy for the question from beautiful Blarney. Question six for Shane and Ciara. Name the iconic sporting legend who joins Nathan Murphy every Thursday on Off the Ball.
John Giles.
Yes. Question seven. What was going on? This is for Andrea and Henry. What was going on in this report? Take a listen from 2013.
Oh my God. Jesus. Fuck. That's so...
Maybe I don't know.
I'm sorry, you don't know.
Henry, if you don't know the answer to this, we're...
Is that you, Henry?
Swearing in there. We should have beeped that out.
Is that you there?
That was me.
Beeped out.
It was a beeped out. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was me. That was 2013. Let me get the year. 2013. It was in Amsterdam.
Yeah.
My then producer, Caroline Clark, had this idea of me going out to Amsterdam to have a baby. And I was like, are you sure? I said, how are we going to pay for that?
Yeah.
So I got on a plane and I went out and I had a baby and it was called Henry's Baby. The name of the baby, Baby David. And it was a simulated childbirth. And it was I was strapped into this machine.
Was it
was very painful at the time. And I'm obviously fat at the moment, but I was thin then. I was, oh God, probably 12 stone then. Let's not talk about my weight now. But and they strapped you into this machine and it simulated labor pains. And afterwards, I actually thought I understood women. I thought I could look into their brains and understand how they felt. But looking
I've
back
always
on it,
felt that about you, Henry, that you...
I understood you.
You can look into my brain and you understand me. I felt that.
Thanks to Henry's baby, but the truth is I don't understand women.
Baby David is 8 now.
Baby David was taken into care.
Bless him.
Anyway, let's not go there.
Like, there's nothing you wouldn't do for a good report. That was a serious...
Well, or even a bad report.
Well, this is it. As long as the cash keeps coming. But no, I won't get naked. That's one thing I won't do.
Really?
No. And I won't jump out of a plane for News Talk. But I'd do anything else.
All right, we will move things on from Henry giving birth to the Battle of George Hook. Shane and Ciara, what was the name of the tool George Hook used at the start of the right hook each day to measure the public mood? This is great.
Oh, yeah, I know this.
Yes.
The happiness index.
Yeah. Well, you would have been closer now to George, Ciara, than most of us.
Steady.
Closer to different parts of George than most of us. How did he work the happiness index? Was it just George's mood, really?
Oh, I'd say so.
Yeah.
I'd say it was based on
mood
apropos
George.
Nothing other than that's what it is. The happiness index is at 7, the lovely Ingrid. I'd say so. I think
first
it was
time I ever appeared on George's show, I just started as a political correspondent and he got me on the show. And before I knew it, I had done impressions of Charlie McCreevy, Michael D. Higgins and some other politician. And I remember walking out of the studio and walking home going, I'm going to be fired. I was the political correspondent and I was doing he got
and
me
look,
doing impersonation.
Look at you now.
I thought, that's it, I'm doomed. Little did I know that's what Newstalk actually wanted. All along. Serious politics? No.
Do us an impression now, go on.
No. I can't do it. No, I need time. I couldn't do it.
I know, he can't help himself.
I know.
He cannot help himself. Can't. This question is for Henry and Andrea. I want you to take a little listen. This is Ivan Yates' first ever tilt at presenting a News Talk. He was covering for George Hook. Take a listen.
The show is The Right Hook. The station is News Talk 106 to 108 FM. And this is Ivan Yates standing in all week for George Hook, who's off sunning himself in South Africa. The good news is George will be back this day next week. Coming up on the programme, has the church got a prayer of getting people back to Mass? A detailed review of all the weekend's action at Croker. And as usual at 6:30, we'll be talking technology with Joe Drumgool, everything from beds to telephones.
Oh, pithy and
smooth.
Smooth. In fairness, it's better than David McWilliams,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, it was better than David McWilliams. I think we're consensus on that. Better than David McWilliams. Question is, what show did Ivan not go on to present? The Hard Shoulder, News Talk Breakfast, Lunchtime Live.
Okay. You know the answer to this.
Of course.
It didn't go on.
Yeah, he didn't go on to present.
Okay.
Never presented it.
He never presented it.
Moncrief.
Lunchtime. That was on the list.
Lunchtime Live.
He didn't list that one.
He filled in for George in Lunchtime Live when it was High Noon.
That it was called High Noon, High Andrea. Noon. That was a different show.
Yeah, but
No.
I lost this one.
That's like saying The Right Hook is the Hard Shoulder.
He never filled in on Moncrief.
Oh, that's controversial.
But that wasn't the question.
Yeah, but no, he never presented the Late Show either, but it was just, I gave you three options, and one of them was the show that you presented.
I know.
Andrea.
You remember that show, Andrea?
No, it wasn't. No, he didn't present. He did.
And
he
gave it up.
I gave it up.
It's gone.
We're
back. We're back in the game.
This is our chance,
Shane. We're back in the game.
Ciara and Shane, back in the game, but this is a tough one. Now, I'm going to,
sorry.
You know what? I'm going to make this a communal question. I'll give it the closest. Whichever team gets closest. How much money in total has been won in the News Talk cash machine up to the end of March?
Oh, I never read that.
Almost half a million.
Is that your final answer?
No.
Hang on, how come they get a question off themselves?
No, don't worry. People always say, this is like Monopoly.
They've chosen that. She said half a million.
Yeah, she didn't let me retract. No,
half a million.
Half a million, that's it, done.
Didn't take long. We've two more rounds to go and we're already going over the rules.
We'll go with just almost half a million. I haven't.
Half a million. Okay, half a million quid.
I think we've given away €12.50. That's it. I mean, come on.
That's
all marketing. It's all marketing. €12.50.
984,000.
We haven't. We haven't.
Wow.
984,000.
Jeez, that's very generous of us.
Yeah, I know.
What a station.
If they scrap that cash machine, think how much
they could
be paying all of us.
Give that money to Shane.
We need to get rid of it.
People that don't answer those ones.
I think about this every day. Yeah. Anyway, 984 grand.
We now ahead here.
Now we're
more importantly,
even
you guys are now 1 point in the lead.
No.
And
yes.
You're giving him that.
And it's their
question.
Well,
we were closer.
It is their question.
Okay. Unbelievable.
This is a farce.
We need KPMG.
So we're level. We're level. Yeah. And if we get this right, we go ahead.
Actually, that's right. You are level.
Draft.
Thank God I'm here.
Yes.
It's like the breakfast show.
So you guys, yeah, exactly. Question 11. Which of the following has not been sheared live on the Moncrief show at the ploughing match? An alpaca, a poodle, or Sean? Did you ever present from ploughing?
Yeah. Yeah. But not nothing to do with Moncrief. Can we confer?
Yes, of course you can confer. While they're conferring, yeah. Henry, you would have gone to the ploughing every year.
I did. I have to say, I'm to blame for the ploughing as a Newstalk going to it.
Oh, go on.
I went to it 1 year and I told our then marketing manager, I went to this ploughing thing. It's amazing. We should definitely get a stall.
This ploughing thing.
And then he went and did some research and said, you know what? Let's get one. And so it's my fault that we were all dragged down there in our Wellingtons every year. And this, that smell of poo. But, you know, we secretly love it. And it's basically urban Ireland for 3 days, just 3 days a year. Basically admitting that rural Ireland exists. That's what it is. we spend 3 days. That's what it is. It's basically the Dublin media saying, yeah, we know you exist for 3 days.
All right. After that patronising assessment of bowing, have you got an answer?
We have conferred.
Well, we were kind of split. I think Sean, Kira thinks the poodle.
No, I think Sean. You think the poodle. No, I think no one has sheared Sean.
Yeah.
No one has sheared Sean Moncrief. No, final answer. No one has sheared Sean Moncrief. Let's take a little look.
The answer is the poodle. I remember the alpaca getting shaved. I also remember getting shaved myself. And the fellow who was doing it was teaching other people how to shave, but he was using a cutthroat razor. He was a little nervous and there was a bit of blood.
So we're all tied.
It's a nail biting into round.
As we take
two.
A very quick break, Andrea and Henry, Shane and Ciara all staying with me. Back in a moment. You're very welcome back to Newstalk's big 20th birthday quiz. I'm grilling Newstalk presenters Ciara Kelly, Shane Coleman. They are on one team and opposing them, Andrea Gilligan and Henry McKean, all tied after round one as we get into round two. I think 4 points apiece is where we are at. And I'm going to start with Andrea and Henry for this one. Who is the, because I think Shane will know the answer too quickly. Who is the Minister for Finance when Newstalk first went on air in 2002? Ooh,
I think Shane kind of gave us a hint earlier.
Bit of whispering going on here. What were the big stories, while they're conferring, what were the big political stories then, Shane?
2002 was the year of a general election. First time I was ever on Newstalk was May 2002, because they covered a general election. I was there as a pollcor.
So. Can you remember, like, because you would have been in the media so at the time, like, was Newstalk's launch, can you remember it?
No.
No.
Ouch, Shane.
Sorry, I can't.
And yet, within a month, you were agreeing to appear.
It was emblazoned on my consciousness. Yeah. It was absolutely.
He often talks really about it now. He kind of gets misty-eyed and he reminisces.
That is the right answer. Henry and Andrea, have you an answer, though, to the question?
So I hope we can get this one right. Fianna Fáil were in power.
They were.
The answer to the question, I hope I'm right here, is Charlie McCreevy.
I think that question's very unfair. So I said it earlier on.
But I think Bertie actually.
Did he launch the station?
He launched the station.
That's right. Bertie did.
Now I remember.
And I remember being told off for calling him Bertie and not on Taoiseach, because I thought everyone called him Bertie, like Boris, you know. But no, you're supposed to say on Taoiseach.
Charlie McCreevy, the correct answer. Back in the lead, Henry and Andrea. And Pat Kenny has the next question for Shane and Ciara.
What I want to know is how many individuals have been Taoiseach since Newstalk came on air 20 years ago?
We had Bertie Ahern, we had Brian Cowan, we had Enda Kenny, we had Leo Varadkar, and we had Micheál Martin. So five.
Five is the correct answer.
I agree with Shane.
Five, Taoiseach, since we came on air. 5 points apiece as well in the quiz. Andrea and Henry, take a listen to this clip for your next question.
Yeah, no, I think it's really important to come home and vote. It's such a big day and it's such an important issue. So hopefully we'll have the whole country behind us.
I actually think that yes, we'll pass in Donegal later on. We'll be finding out quite soon.
Well, I want to tell you folks, if you're just getting out of the scratchers, 9:41 on Saturday morning, Ivan says the yes are going to win by a landslide.
Bundoran has voted yes, Ballyshannon has voted yes, Carrick-on-Suir has voted yes, North Wicklow, South Wicklow, North Wexford, rural North Wexford, all have voted yes.
I think it shows the empowerment of young people. It shows that the mothers and fathers of Ireland voted yes. And I think it makes the most modernising statement Irish society has ever made.
Yeah, so it's one of two referenda, obviously.
Yes, yeah.
Which one, though? That's what Bundoran said. Yeah, that's rare now that Donegal would say yes to anything.
I remember being sent up there, and it was Garrett Hart, the then station manager or editor or whatever his title was at the time.
Editor in chief.
Was it?
If you're listening, Garrett.
Super, super, super editor chief. Yeah, so he said he was convinced that he was a Donegal man. They would vote no.
He was convinced that you were as a Donegal man.
And he sent me up there, and there was ruptions. They even had a protest about my report on the Green the next day, saying that I was making out that they were hillbillies, which wasn't the case at all. We were just trying to bring attention.
You're joking. People protested.
Yeah, they
you.
Protested. They were upset with the report because we were bringing... And they voted. They just about voted yes. It was very, very close. But I got a rude awakening up there. And do you know something? I haven't been back since.
What?
I'm worried. I can't go to Bunkranna.
It's a very long answer.
I'm not welcome. Yeah,
since when? What referendum?
Oh,
was
sorry.
That?
Oh, there was. Oh, it was.
Question
it was.
In there.
It was the same sex marriage referendum.
Yeah, you're right. It was.
I love the way. I loved Ivan's. Ivan says it's over. So the whole country. There was an exit poll. But not until Ivan says it.
All right. Well, we've got another clip for the next question, and this is for Shane and Ciara. What was this trend that all News Talk presenters jumped on board with?
I've been nominated for this by Rob Carney. Thanks a lot, Rob. I'll see you soon.
Do it now!
That's Coleman by four.
We know this, don't we?
Did you do it?
Yes.
No, I wasn't important enough.
Did you not do it?
No.
No one nominated you.
I was nominated by so many people.
No.
No.
I would have nominated
you. I think I did it with the kids in the back garden.
Did you? You did it, Ciara,
yeah? I did, yeah. And it was very cold.
I bet you, it was in my eye. I bet you did. You did it with lukewarm water.
I did not.
Yeah, you did.
I
remember.
There was from the jacuzzi.
I lived in a very fancy house at the time.
You still live in a very fancy
house. I lived in a much fancier house at the time, and there was kind of a stone balustrade up the side of the house, and somebody off the top of it.
The ice bucket challenge.
None of that out the backyard.
I'm telling you. I shouldn't have said any of that. I retract
you
that.
You really do walk into some of
these things.
Yeah, exactly. Anyway.
I'm so unfiltered. It's a terrible mistake.
The ice bucket challenge is, of course, the correct answer. Andrea and Henry, what event were these members of the public talking to our reporter about?
Well, I think the sooner we get out, the better. People are fed up with being dictated to. I mean, it's totally undemocratic. People are still angry that we voted to come out because they're misguided.
You know the answer to this, Henry. Did you go to the UK much?
I did. I travelled around during that whole time, various areas, including a place called Jaywick that had 75% Brexit vote. So I think the answer to your question is Brexit.
It is. Yes. It is. Shane, you went. Tell your Ian Paisley Jr. story.
I went over for one of the key votes, and I was obviously, look, I was well behind the queue in terms of the BBC and ITN, all trying to get people. And I saw Ian Paisley Jr. there, and I said, okay, look, he's from the island of Ireland. He'll
fellow Irishman.
An interview. And I just said, Ian, is there any chance of just a really quick interview? He said, no, I'm walking back. I'm walking back over to the House of Commons. I said, I'll walk back over to you. He said, I'm eating a sandwich. And I said, you're not eating a sandwich. And he popped the sandwich in his mouth. I'm eating a sandwich. That was it. You're a nice guy. Thanks for that.
Stuffed his face full of food.
So he wouldn't have to speak into those tags.
My logo used to be orange.
You'd known about the orange Vespas.
Yeah, exactly.
That's what would have done. Brexit, of course. Henry is right. Brexit was the answer. For our next question, we're joined by the one and only Jess Kelly.
At the end of 2019, we ran a series looking at the top 20 most influential moments of the last 20 years. Our listeners voted and placed a techie innovation at number one. Can you tell me what it was?
Can I just say, first of all, that Jess Kelly looks lovely in that. Very nice.
There's no...
That doesn't buy you points.
Jess is not
tallying the scores. I'm just being
nice. Scores. Jess
You're
is
all
not tallying the scores.
Cynics. or is it the WWW?
It must be the WWW, is it?
If the last 20 years...
Hang on.
Oh, that's a bit older than that.
That's a bit older than that now.
But then it is the iPhone.
Not for me, it wasn't.
Hang on, we're still preferring.
2002. The internet was around before 2002.
The smartphone.
The iPhone. I'll give you that. The smartphone.
It
we'll
is
give
what
you a smartphone.
Yeah.
Full points to Shane and Ciara, the smartphone. The next question is, I've lost track of the scores, so I'm going to say it's about evens.
We're ahead.
No, we're evens.
Oh, we're evens.
Yeah.
Sorry.
All right.
Always claim you're ahead.
No, I think
7-7.
Yeah, 7 points apiece. The next question is for Andrea and Henry. Michael D. Higgins was elected president in 2011. Who was the Fine Gael candidate in that election?
Ooh. Teacher.
Okay, let's go back.
Eunthor.
It's awful to distill someone's while they're conferring their entire political career down to this one thing. But in the mid-90s, didn't he have to bring in the Olympics to Dublin? And then in response, Dustin had a campaign, bring the dart to Dingle.
That's right.
And I cannot hear mention of this politician without thinking, bring the dart to Dingle. All right, I'm going to have to force you for an answer now.
To hurry you.
Andrea.
No, oh, yes, it was. You got it.
Go, Andrea.
Genuinely.
Yeah, Andrea has the answer.
I don't know why I think it's Gay Mitchell.
It is Gay. Because it's the right answer, Andrea.
I covered it and I had actually forgot. Andrea said it and I was like, you're right. I
mean,
it was Gay.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, Gay Mitchell is, of course, the answer. 1 point ahead now, Andrea and Henry. And we've got a few musical questions coming up. So for the two musicians in the house, this should be easy. Should be an easy round. Shane and Ciara, what was the number one song in Ireland on the week that Newstalk launched in 2002?
Ooh. Okay, we know it's September. April 2002.
April 2002.
I'm going to play a clip and give you a hint.
Okay. It's obviously Unchained Melody.
Yeah, but I need the singer.
No idea.
No, don't say that. We'll just guess. It's probably like an Irish.
You can think. Right,
an Irish boy bandy type.
A man or a woman?
Think, man.
Think this through. So what was like at the time? What was getting big on television?
Boy band. Oh, hang on.
No, it was kind of just
X Factor was getting really big.
Now you're right.
Was it the Irish one? The Irish version.
No. Across the pond.
There was those guys who were there was two of them. Will.
Will Young. Who was the better singer,
of
I might
the
suggest.
Two, and the other.
Garrett something or other.
Yes.
Garrett. Brooks. Garrett.
Gates.
Oh, I like that. I like your question worked out. But a few prompts. Of course it was. Garrett Gates. The next question is going to be asked by the one Tom Dunn.
Can you tell me what year did Marqueta Irglova and Glenn Hansard win the Oscar for the song Falling Slowly, best original song from the film Once?
That's for Andrea and Henry.
With the year they won the Oscar, not the year the movie came out.
The year they won the Oscar.
Okay, I'm going to go 2008.
Yes, bingo. Good.
Yes.
Well done.
That's Henry. Very good.
I still haven't seen the movie.
It's quite nice.
Next question for Shane and Ciara. This was the theme tune for which long-running News Talk show?
We are going to say we think it's The Right Hook.
It is certainly The Right Hook. So you know, you should both know that.
Yeah, we should both know
music.
That.
Very well. You got a great trip to the States out of that gig you had on The Right Hook.
Fantastic trip. And on the way home, there was some kind of mix-up and I ended up getting pushed up into first class.
Oh, sweet.
And the kids were all at a certain age. They were all quite young. And it was just the idea of sitting there with nobody annoying me, drinking wine, reading, watching films. And there was a tailwind behind the plane. And we got there an hour and a half early. I was disgusted. I just wanted to sit. If he'd said an hour and a half delayed, I would have been thrilled.
Anyway, the answer is The Right Hook. That was the theme music for it. We've got another clip for our next question. This is for Andrea and Henry. Take a listen. This is Henry himself speaking to Jonathan Healy back in 2014.
He was the biggest selling artist of the 90s. Of course, he went into semi-retirement back in 2001, and then he went on to Vegas, and now he's making a comeback at 51. And I actually put that to him about his weight. I compared him to, I suppose, how Ireland loves Supermax, and he, I suppose, is bigger than Supermax. And I meant it as a compliment, because to be honest with you, I'm looking at pictures here, he has been bigger. He looks quite well, to be honest, and he played the last time he was in Ireland was a whole 17 years ago. So a lot of his fans weren't even born, and he's got friends in some very, very low places.
I mean, how did you get away with this, Henry?
I can't believe how enthusiastic I sound. Yeah. It was Garth Brooks, and in some parts of Ireland, they call him Garrett Brooks, which is okay.
Brooks, though, of course, is the right answer. And I want Shane and Ciara to take a listen to this clip. Not the question is not what you think it is.
What is
that
it?
Was the music, the theme music for the lunchtime show with Eamon Keane from 2006 to 2009. Wow. That was The Killers. Jenny was a friend of mine.
Yeah.
What was the name of that album from The Killers?
Oh, Jesus.
It was a global hit.
Yeah,
huge. It sounds like a movie that was part of a series, that kind of Simon Pegg series of movies. That was out about 15, 20 years ago as well. 15 years ago.
What do you mean?
Like
hot. Yeah.
Hot.
And all.
Go on.
I don't know. I can't. No.
No, wait.
No, go on.
We can't say nothing. It sounds like a movie in that series. I know the album. It was huge.
You obviously know a movie in that series, though, because you just mentioned a movie in that series. Why don't you
hear
that as your answer?
Hot. Fear
Fuzz.
Well done, Ciara. You got there. Tentatively.
Oh, absolutely.
But Ciara got there in the end. Hot Fuzz was the name of that album. This is it. This is our final musical question. This one is for Andrea and Henry. Take a listen to this.
Well, it's a marvelous night for a moon dance with the stars up above in your eyes. A fantabulous night to make romance. Meet the cover of October skies. And all the leaves on the trees.
That was December 2013. Newstalk reunited the Chieftains and this astronaut to perform Moondance. He had previously performed it that year while he was still on the International Space Station.
I thought it was Ivan Yates singing it.
Name the astronaut.
Okay, you know the
you don't like this astronaut.
Rather than astronaut. Okay, so
Shane Coleman doesn't. You know, Shane Coleman really dislikes this astronaut.
But what
Henry
has
an idea.
Well, no, it's the Canadian astronaut.
Yes, it is.
He flirted heavily with Newstalk, and we flirted heavily with him.
Mm-hmm.
And I think we even spoke to him live from the International Space Station. And I remember Chris Donahue became friends. They were friends with this guy. And you're going to ask me.
I think if you ask Chris, he says he's friends with the guy. I think if you ask the astronaut,
he won't know who he is.
He might say, Chris who?
And he has a moustache. Did an advert for ESPN.
Can we get a name here?
I can't remember the name.
We got a clue.
They got a clue. Yeah.
He has a big moustache. That's the clue.
I just don't know the name.
They just said that. That was the clue they provided themselves. You're not a million miles away with the Newstalk presenter, the former presenter you just mentioned.
Yeah.
Oh,
okay.
Same first name, basically.
Okay, Chris.
Yes.
It's the pressure of the quiz. I know the answer.
You put on your hands.
Don't say that. He's going to be sore.
That's it. Yeah. She's got it.
Go on.
Hadfield?
Yes, Andrea, Chris Hadfield.
I'm so sorry, Chris Hadfield, I forgot your name.
That is it. And that
you're not as good friends as him and Chris.
To the end of round two on our big 20th birthday quiz, and the scores on the doors, 11 points to Henry and Andrea, a mere 10.
Hang on.
No, Shane.
We're level.
We didn't drop any.
You were given the Right Hook theme tune as a question.
We didn't get a point for it.
Say again.
So we didn't get a point for it.
This is less mastermind, more shooting stars. I decided. the scores are 11-10, and we're going to take a very quick break. You're welcome back to Newstalk's big 20th birthday quiz. The scores on the doors, Shane and Ciara, a mere 10 points. Andrea and Henry out in the lead on 11 points. Let's see if you can see it home now in the final round. I'm going to start with Shane and Ciara for this question. Coming from Ger Gilroy, the only presenter from that first day in 2002 still on the air.
Wow.
2020 News, the headlines. The Republic of Ireland manager Mick McCarthy has bizarrely sent home his best player and captain and one of the best players in the world, Roy Keane, just before the start of the World Cup in 2002 from a place called Saipan. Luckily, we will never talk about this incident again and we will maturely deal with the fallout of it for the rest of our lives by never mentioning it and certainly not going over it again in the next few weeks. Luckily, from our perspective, we just launched a brand new nightly sports show and everybody was telling us, you're not going to have anything to talk about to fill, as it was then, a nightly 2-hour show. Well,
I guess we should really say thank you to Mick McCarthy for sending his best player home in advance of the World Cup and us never finding out what it would have been like if Roy Keane had actually played in the tournament. Anyway, the question is, who took over as the captain of the Republic of Ireland at the 2002 World Cup? Best of luck.
Oh, good question, Jar. All right. Who took over? Shane, you know the answer to this.
Come I presume on. It's Staunton, is it?
Bang.
I was just thinking.
Did you say bang?
Yeah.
He just said bang. Give me the don't points.
Steve Staunton. Yeah. Got it. Got it. Yeah. Won. All right. No need to think about it anymore. Trust your gut.
The That's man I made the... cry when he was 12 years old.
Oh, so I don't even want to hear this story again. I've heard the story. Have you not heard the story?
Everyone's heard this story.
I haven't heard the story.
Scored a goal against him in the under 12 Dundalk Cup semi final and he cried after the game. And so I made Steve Staunton cry.
His team
were all conquering. They won every game.
The man
won that one
he is
game.
Today. Anyway, Steve Staunton did take over after Roy Keane was sent home. And Jura's right. We never went on to talk about Saipan again. The next question for Andrea and
Henry. Until June, we'll be talking about it for the 20th anniversary.
Who scored the winning goal against Germany at the Aviva to help Ireland reach the Euros in Poland?
I was at the match.
Okay, you remember the answer.
God, of course I don't remember. Okay, who was it? Who scored the winning goal to get us into Poland? Oh, Jesus, I was at that match.
Technically, it didn't get us into Poland. It got us into a playoff and we beat Bosnia.
Yeah, that's true.
Thank you very much for that.
And the scores that night were...
Yeah, it was... Oh, what's his... And it's...
Describe him. I don't have a clue. Not that I'd know.
He was a macho little man.
also France, not Poland, by the way.
Okay, who was it? I know this. I can't believe I was at the game and I can't remember. But I'm going to try.
Just... Say okay, somebody because
okay,
I don't have a clue.
Was it 2000? What year was that? 2008.
Sorry, it wasn't the Poland.
No,
it was the France Euros.
It was the French France Euros. Euros. Yeah.
So the
France Euros. Later,
2015.
He was a former. He hurled minor with.
Ah, come on.
He hurled minor with tip.
Actually, that's a grand.
That wouldn't be. Sorry, that's what it is. Come on.
Okay, he said he was on living with Lucy. That would be a lot easier.
Scare's mud.
No, I know it was. Yeah, we went into France, and no one thought we'd beat Germany, and we beat Germany.
Yeah, come on.
And
it was this preamble is nearly.
I can't give you a name.
Okay,
I'm sorry.
I'm gonna give you a countdown.
Just say someone. Just say something. It's.
I have a blank. I don't want to get it wrong. I don't know.
Long-term.
I don't know.
All right. No.
Shane Long's on fire.
Shane, I'm giving the points to Shane Coleman for having got that answer right. Okay. And you two getting it wrong. That's the first.
Darren Randolph got the assist.
And not only now have they drawn level, they've actually pulled ahead. You're a point ahead. That's double it. Points.
It's always going to happen.
Yeah. Game rules.
This is it. Or rather, you now have the opportunity. Or are you ahead?
Who knows?
Yeah, we are now.
No, you're ahead. You're ahead.
Take it up. It's fine.
For the first time in this game, which of the following names did Lance Armstrong call Jer Gilroy in their very tense interview? Spider-Man, Superman, or the Hulk?
Oh, God.
Remember that interview?
Spider-Man, Superman. It must have been...
Either Superman or the Hulk. Why would he call him Spider-Man?
The Hulk.
Wrong. Incorrect. You had a chance. You had a chance to put a bit of daylight between yourselves.
Okay, so the question was Spider-Man,
Superman or the Hulk?
Or the Hulk.
I remember the interview really well.
I'm going to make a guess.
Yeah, please do.
I think it's the Hulk.
Henry, what a missed opportunity. The answer, of course, Superman.
Oh, sorry.
You're off the hook
Superman.
There.
Sorry.
Don't make her angry, Henry. You wouldn't like her when she's angry.
We can actually take a little listen to that clip.
Don't be silly. Here's the thing, Jared. I sat in that room, not only with Greg and Kathy, I sat in that room with his lawyer, and with my lawyer, and there were plenty of other people in that room, and I apologized to them. Nope, never at any time did Greg and or Kathy say, hey, we feel like you owe us financially, right? And I don't need to get into the details of the conversation. The most important part was that I was sorry for my actions, I was embarrassed by my actions, and I apologized to them, and they accepted the apology.
Okay, I don't think they did accept the apology. It seems that's certainly...
You weren't in the room. What are you talking about?
Well, I've got pretty good sources.
Oh, okay. Okay, Superman.
Okay.
All right, next question. There's still a point down, Henry and Andrea. And the next question is from Bobby Kerr.
Okay, folks, can you tell me which former US president correctly told me I have a great business show?
It has to be Trump.
You can.
So, would he... Did he get an interview with Trump? Or is it Clinton? Oh.
I'm going to push you for an answer.
Oh, okay. I'm going to let you decide.
I'd say Trump.
Absolutely. Yeah. Andrea's right. Let's take a listen.
And the other thing I always tell people, Bobby, is you have to love what you do. Like, I can tell how much you love your show and you do it well, and that's why it's so good and
thanks
so successful. But you really have to love what you do. And if you love it, you're not working.
Thank you for joining us.
Well, thank you very much, Bobby. It's been an honor, and you have a fantastic show, and I look forward to talking to you again.
Yeah.
Was that before or after Ivan Yates absolutely grilled Trump?
Oh, grilled him. Oh. Because they got that answer right, you're on level scores.
Okay.
So there's going to be a bit of a kind of a rapid fire element to the rest of them, right?
Okay.
We're going to try and answer them as quickly as we can and determine who really is the news talk expert in the room. Okay, next question is for Shane and Ciara. What was the name of the show presented by Sheila Shoiga on News Talk?
I know it.
Doesn't matter, Andrea.
Why?
Because the question isn't for you.
Speak Irish.
No.
Irish is the incorrect answer. It goes across. Andrea?
Andrea knows the answer.
It's shenanigans.
Shenanigans. Sheila, that's correct. Yeah. Andrea and Henry in the lead. And the next question is for them. Which itchy part of George Hook's anatomy did Ciara Kelly regularly provide updates on in her weekly medical slot on the right hook?
His scrotum.
His scrotum is the correct answer.
I didn't know that. I thought they were
now
his forehead.
2 points in
my
the lead.
Finest
but the
hour.
Next question is for Shane and Ciara. Can you name this former News Talk breakfast presenter?
Good morning. You're listening to News Talk 106 to 108 FM.
Claire Byrne.
Claire Byrne is the correct answer. So the gap has been shortened to a single point. Name the slot on the Moncrief where everyone gets drunk every week.
Movies and Booze.
Movies and Booze. 2 point lead. A staple part of the annual News Talk calendar, Shane and Ciara. Of course, the plowing, which we mentioned earlier. Who is Bobby Kerr speaking to in this clip from the 2018 event?
What are you up to now? What are the plans for the next while? Are you starting to take things a bit easier? You never seem to have taken much of a break.
Bobby, why should I take a break?
Yeah.
I love what I do. I have a passion for what I do. And it was very exciting to come to this ploughing competition. Just very sad that the weather was so bad.
Who was it?
Is it Mary Berry?
Mary Berry is the correct
yes!
answer. Follow-up question. I'm going to let you draw level with this follow-up question. Right. Who was meant to interview Mary Berry that day?
Jonathan.
Incorrect. I'm going to hand it over. Henry, who should have answered?
Kieran Cuddihy
is the answer. I was stuck. I meant to interview her at the ploughing and I was down there and I baked a cake for Mary Berry to taste and everything. And then that was the year the storm, the ploughing was cancelled and I got stuck in the traffic. Bobby had to run across to her hotel in Dublin and interview Mary Berry.
Oh, wow.
So that's it. So that was an opportunity to close the gap instead.
They've
got
on.
2 points
Go
ahead
on.
And it is their Vegas question. Twist. Before joining News Talk, Shane Coleman was political editor and correspondent of which Sunday newspaper?
The Tribune.
The Sunday Tribune. They're now 3 points ahead. What is the name?
More about you.
What is the name of Henry McKean's mother, a regular feature in News Talk throughout the years?
Oh, God.
If you get this wrong, right?
It's mum.
Yeah.
Mrs. McKean. Yeah.
Not Mrs. McKean.
No, I've heard her so many times.
It's mummy.
Okay, I'm going to have to push you for an answer.
No, Margaret. No.
You were close with the last one, but if you put a plant before that.
Hyacinth. No. That's,
that's, what is this? You're going to. That's gone. Wipe
out. Hyacinth Mary. No.
No. Right, they've answered. Good luck.
Rosemary.
Rosemary. There it is.
There it is.
So close.
That is a totally legitimate answer. Rosemary. How many members of Westlife has Andrea interviewed?
Oh, boom. In News Talk or throughout my life?
In News Talk.
Two
is the correct answer. How many days of walking does Ciara Kelly go on about every year?
100.
Not too many.
100. It feels like too many. 100.
I would have accepted too many. Which member of the Oireachtas presented a Sunday show in News Talk from 8 to 11?
Ooh.
Current member of the Oireachtas.
Current?
Okay. Used to. Back in the day.
Yeah, doesn't it?
Okay.
Yes, Henry. Nobody on the schedule at the moment. It's a city.
Let's get right into the office.
Okay, I'm gonna make a stab at it. It is our question, isn't it?
Yes.
David Norris.
David Norris is the correct answer. He did present a Sunday show. Which presenter once hosted News Talk Breakfast in his boxer shorts? Shane and Ciara.
Hang on. Watch.
Beautiful mental
image. So none of you are your various cohorts then?
No. Don't think so.
Was it Nora Casey? Did she do it?
No. Nora Casey did not do it in her boxer shorts.
No,
the answer is Eamon Dunphy. Eamon Dunphy.
You didn't send it our way.
I didn't, because you're too far ahead.
We are on the home run.
To the closest whole number, how many tampons did Ciara Kelly receive in the post as part of her campaign in 2020?
Okay. Yeah. This question's to us.
This question is to you.
You want the Christ. Amount.
Yeah, how many tampons did she get?
Okay, and she will know the answer to this. You're going to give
of
it to her?
That's why I'm asking you, Henry.
Okay, it was. I'm going to say 4,320.
No.
Was it 18,000? I don't know how many it was.
Oh, Ciara, come on. I would have given you double points. It would have got you back in for a tiebreaker question.
It was about 24,000 or something, wasn't it?
I'm going to say 30,000.
None of you are right. 13,000 was the correct.
Oh.
What is the name of Newstalk's long-running history programme?
Talking history.
Okay.
Load of history.
Well, that question was actually for Shane and Ciara. They got it correct. Andrea interrupted thereby
she
breaking the
rules. Loses how many points?
Loses 3 points, which puts us on even score. So we have a tiebreaker question.
Oh, tiebreaker question
to decide the entire quiz.
I need a buzzer.
So, tiebreaker question, and I'm going to give the points and the prize to whoever shouts out the answer first. Okay?
All right.
So, fingers on proverbial buzzers. What was the name of the controversial US contributor?
Michael Graham.
Oh, very quick.
In tandem,
answer.
In unison.
Shane
very
and
good.
Ciara. Absolutely
well
quick.
Done.
Well done, Shane and Ciara. Commiserations to.
Well,
Henry
you deducted us 3 points, but anyway, let's go.
So I'd like to award you your prize. This is a very important prize. I hope you cherish it. This can now adorn maybe over the balustrades, Ciara, in the mansion in Greystones.
I'm going
there
to
it is.
When
Pat Kenny. There you go.
Pat Kenny, back in, I'd say, 1982.
Back when
and his face beautifully on,
that's
on
last
a,
year,
on a vinyl.
And I think we can all agree his face still beautiful today. Congratulations, Ciara and
Shane.
And again,
well done, guys.
And thank you, folks. And thank you, everybody, for listening.